What are we doing?
Oh, what are we doing? What's up, guys? Today we are doing... What song are we doing?
I thought you wrote that down.
Why would I write that down?
Brighton Rock.
Okay, what's Brighton Rock about?
Oh, Lord.
I don't know what this song's about.
I really don't know what it's about either. All that I really can tell you. Okay, I did... Just so everybody knows, I did very little
research. Saying that ahead of time.
Saying that ahead of time, I went to a site that nobody has ever told me to go to before. And, you know, tried to put it together with some other sites where people were making comments on it and whatnot. And
so what is your understanding
and
of it?
So from the lyrics, guy and a girl go on public holiday, okay, they meet. Mm-hmm. Okay, she's like, I can't tell my mom what I did on this holiday. He's like, oh, you know, come on, you know, you can, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then by the end of the song, he's like saying, yeah, I can't tell anybody either because he's got like a girlfriend or a wife or somebody back home. So it seems like it's one of those, what's done in Vegas stays in Vegas type of things.
One of those type of things.
Okay. What I do know is that before we pulled up this particular version, which is the official lyric video, and somebody had just said, go look at Brighton Rock.
Yeah.
Not knowing what I was looking at, I pulled up Brighton Rock, which is really what it is. It was
an 8-minute guitar solo.
Brighton Rock solo, and I think was 86 from Wembley, I think.
Okay, probably.
And it was a good 7.5 minutes of all it was Brian playing this huge solo.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. My understanding is that during this time frame with progressive rock as a whole, a lot of groups were used to doing these kind of longer solos.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that, you know, so like if Brian's out there and he's doing his thing for 7 minutes, everybody else can be off the side drinking water, resting their voice, you know, all that kind of stuff.
And then they come back on and he dies it down a little bit.
They all do their thing and they finish out the song.
Yeah.
Okay. Or, you know, this huge 5-minute drum solo or, you know, I mean, other bands, you know, would do drum solos and stuff like that.
Right.
So that's what I was... So I was just seeing his solo, which was really cool. That's why I asked you to check out, you know, with some other people. If I was looking at the right thing, were there actually lyrics to this song? Or was it just this, you know, 7.5-minute solo?
Right.
What I did find out on this particular site that I was looking at...
What's the site, by
was
the way?
That... Oh, I can't.
Queensongs.info. Okay.
And
seems reputable.
And what I liked about this site is that they actually break
down.
They break the song. Well, not necessarily just what it means, but they actually break the song down, basically verse by verse by verse by verse, musically as well.
Mm-hmm.
And they got really super complicated in regard to all of that, so we're not even going to talk about that.
He was getting confused reading all
I was it. Getting confused reading. I mean, but they were saying that one of these, you know, during the concert when they would play this, that's again when they would give everybody kind of a rest, as far as their voice was concerned, that the longest solo that they did, because Queen didn't like doing these solos, like all these other bands did, except for this. And the longest that these particular folks could find was approximately 15 minutes long. And it actually ended with Roger doing a timpani solo at the end of it. Okay, so it wasn't just Brian, but it was Roger as well.
Right.
They also, what was the other thing that I thought was, really cool? I'm probably not going to be able to find it, but was that at the very beginning, that you hear all these noise, all this noise. Like, you know, like a carnival going on or a fair or something like that.
No work.
And in the, I caught you. I heard it. And
heard
in
what?
The, exactly. So, but there were three distinct, like tunes that were going on. One was like a marching band. One was a street organ.
Mm-hmm.
And then one, and I could just barely hear it, you know, through here and listen for it at the very beginning, is you hear this whistling.
Mm-hmm.
And the whistling is the tune, is the what do you call it, the outro?
Okay.
Of Seven Seas Arrive from the previous album that they did. Okay.
It's from Queen 2.
So as they were, and this is the next one right after Queen 2.
I think from
Sure Heart Attack. Okay.
I think those were the two.
Yeah. So they said at the end of Seven Seas Rye, as it's fading out and you're hearing these sounds, okay,
yeah,
that this is basically the same thing leading into this song.
Yeah.
You know, and you can hear them whistling the outro, outro to Seven Seas Rye.
Yeah. I forget what song it was, but one of my friends, he's got the CD and it goes from like track 6 to 7 or something like that. And the end of track 6 is a really, really, really heavy instrument piece. And then it's crescendo, crescendo, boom, right into track 7.
Okay.
And they go right into each other.
Okay.
And if you take them apart and it's just, you know, track 6, you know, crescendoing up, it ends.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a good ending.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you just take track 7, it starts really loud. But you put them together and it goes right into the next one. So this is kind of how that is.
Right.
To a sense.
Right, right. Well, I guess.
Well, I mean, they go right into each other. That's
my
point. But
they're two completely different albums, though.
Right. So, but it's the connecting from the one to the other.
It would be interesting to find out. I don't know that. You know, I'm just, like I say, I'm just reading what they, you know, what is put in front of me. But,
right.
So it'd be kind of interesting to hear that ending.
Yeah.
Okay, and then hear this beginning and see what it actually does. But that's what they're saying in here. So, but anyway.
You good?
Anyway, yeah, I'm good. I want to hear this thing.
All right.
There's not a whole lot of lyrics and he does sing it really fast. So, be glad that you're looking at the lyric video.
That's why it was recommended.
So, anyway, yeah, when you're ready.
All right. Let's get started with this, guys.
I'm good to go. There's the whistling. Happy birthday, so decorously laid in the gay illuminations of London.
do not crumble. Love is breathing still. Ah, Lady Moonshine down. A little people magic if you will.
That's how you take about a minute and a half verse, a minute and a half worth of lyrics, mm-hmm. and turn it into a 15-minute song. Because there weren't a whole lot of lyrics,
mm-hmm.
right? And you saw the very ending,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Of her saying, you know, I want to be in touch. I want this.
Yeah.
You know, I'm in love with you. And then have this guy said, "Oh, sorry."
Gotta
apologize. Can't ever find out. You know. Oh, really? You know.
It's like, yeah, so, thanks.
But how'd you like Brian doing his thing?
There were so many different implements that he put into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You had some very, very, very light things in there where it's just going to, you know, keep it going or whatever, and there's just a few little light, you know, strums or something like that. And then there was, and then it turned into a rock feel. and then it turned into kind of like a swing type ballad, you know, whatever, and then back into a rock feel. He threw so many different, you know, things in there, and wasn't part of that from, part of that I picked out from one of their Smile songs.
What?
It sounded familiar.
Okay. What, it's funny that you mentioned that. Apparently, this particular, his particular solo, now you gotta remember, this was the album version.
Right.
Okay, so they had to, you know, couldn't be a 15-minute thing.
Right.
Okay. Apparently, it all started back with Smile, the song called, and everyone has to, Blag? B-L-A-G is okay. how they spelled it. That he had
Log,
that he had this solo.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then when it, then as the years went on, the solo became more embellished and enhanced. And, you know, as he became better creatively.
Mm-hmm. And musically.
Okay. Well, that's what I mean. Right. Yeah, you know. And he was learning more and more about music and what they refer to as canons and
all this other stuff.
And all this other stuff.
Right.
Yeah, that's where I got lost in all of this. So I'm not even going to talk about that stuff. But they mentioned, I will say they mentioned in here, you know, now in this verse or in this particular section, he put in the Hendrix chord.
Okay.
Or something like that, and you start thinking, oh, this is like from his Jimi Hendrix influence,
right?
You know, something, and he starts putting these things in, but eventually, he got it
right.
7, 8, 9, 10, 15 minutes long. Whatever,
yeah,
whatever the case is, but they did mention that he first started. The infant was born when he was in Smile.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So anyway, I thought it was at the very beginning, you know, when they started, when the lyrics first started, and you know, how it was so super high.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I'm thinking, did they...
It's Roger.
No, it was Freddie.
It was Freddie?
It's according to this, I thought it was Roger too, and I was thinking, you know,
because he went from all the way up here to all the way down here in the next verse,
and it actually says, let's see, in the first verse, Freddie starts his lead vocal part in falsetto. He switches to a normal voice in measure 10.
Yeah,
between the two syllables of the word magic.
Yeah,
causing a. They whatever a hocket is, a hocket like effect. And then the second verse changes from normal to falsetto between the two phrases and switches back again on the magic word. This is to represent the dialogue between a man and a woman.
Mm-hmm.
So, woman, man,
that's just cool. And going between the two syllables of a word,
yeah,
and making that drop, that's
and then when the word comes up and then doing it again,
yeah,
you know, going the other direction,
going back up, yeah, that's
but I thought it was Roger too,
yeah,
you know, and then as I started looking at this, because I don't ever remember hearing Freddie singing
that
falsetto that much,
no,
you know, so, but you got to remember this was back in the early days too, you know, so. Still had his voice, right?
Yeah, right.
So, and they also, well, that, you know, that's really, you know, so anyway, it,
mm-hmm.
you know, it was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
It was definitely interesting listening to Brian do his thing.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of going through all this technical stuff that I was reading on this site in regard to all the different things that he was actually doing
mm-hmm.
in all of this. Because, again, on this, again, it's called Queen Songs Info.
Yeah, so queensongs.info.
.info.
Yeah.
And Queen Songs Recording and, Recording and Songwriting. And you go under Song Analysis, and that's what it all,
yeah.
you know, and they break this sucker down stanza by stanza, you know.
Because so, all songs are just long poems. That's all they are.
We'll talk about that. That's another conversation for a different day.
That's a Patreon story.
Yeah, it's actually... It's another story. That's what I thought at one point, too. But anyway, until I was taught how to write a lyric. So, but that's really, that's it. As far as I'm can, you know, I'm good.
Okay. Okay. Ooh. Brightness is not doing good on us.
Look at that.
No.
Oh, but let me come back.
Yeah, brightness is not doing very
good. How about if I sit back here? Because if I get up here, look at that. I need to... Oh, if I do that...
Chrome dome.
Look at that. I can... Did you see that? I was able to erase it right off.
Something's acting up with our light here.
That's pretty cool. Okay.
Anyway, guys, don't forget that Teespring link down below. Where we've got the hoodies, the long sleeve t-shirts, regular t-shirts, tank tops, breast cancer awareness t-shirts, mugs, phone cases for both iPhone and Android users. Get those while you can, because again, I keep saying this, and I promise we are, that we are working on some new designs and some new logos for you guys. So if you want any of the original logos, get those while you can, because they may not be up very much longer.
Cool.
Along with that Patreon link that's also down in the description below. If you don't know what Patreon is our VIP tier that we got going on, that you get exclusive videos, you get one-on-one communication with us, you get to leave personalized comments for us, you get to help us with any questions we may have. Yeah, it's just all around a fun time. You get to know about information before we release it out to the public. You know, announcements, stuff like that. But again, the exclusive videos are now the you know, the primary thing on there. So if you don't want to miss out on things that aren't going to be seen on YouTube, always check out Patreon. You never fail being on Patreon. Anyway, I get to thank the following patrons who've helped pledge to make this video possible. That'd be Paula Johnson, Patricia Miller, Teresa Anderson, Hot Space, Ann Petro, Karen Barone, Sandy Thomas, Courtney Turek, Cindy Rice, and Don Kula. Thank you so much for your guys' constant love and support of this channel, guys. We really, really, really do appreciate you. You know, you are the fire. That's why we have those fire emblems next to your names. You are the fire that help fuel us to keep going. So we really, really, really appreciate that.
Yep.
Again, if you want to get your name in the description as well, or any of the perks that I just listed, that link is down below. Yep. Also remember, guys, at 1,000 subscribers, we will open up a P.O. box. So if you would like to send us things, you can. We are rearing in on 700 right about now.
We are close.
Super close to 700. Yep. So we're... I think at this point in time, we're 307 away.
Something to that.
I think we're 307 away. So if you guys would like to help make history for us and help us reach that goal quicker, whether you want to send us something or whether you don't want to send us anything, that's completely up to you. But make sure you click that subscribe button so you do not miss what is to come from this channel. Well, I will tell you. The number, as of now, currently standing, is 693.
All right.
So I was right.
307.
307. Again, guys, so if you want to help us meet that goal, or even if you don't want to help us meet that goal, click that subscribe button. And it is free. It's just the two clicks, one to subscribe and one for the post notification bell, so you get notified whenever we release anything from this channel.
Yep.
All right, you good?
Awesome.
Alrighty, guys. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to smack that like button, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace out, guys.